And now on Art Street, an inside view of Art Basel with one of the guiding lights behind this international art event, businessman and art collector Norman Brahman. Art Street now, the show is that you're on, it's going to its 9th season. So it was about maybe 2 years before that that I met with you and our general manager. You said you need to have an art show. And I remember hearing that. You told me what it should be, and I had never forgotten that. And 2 years later, we had the show, which is now 9 years old.
Wow.
Our 9th season.
That's wonderful.
So I just want you to know that you were the impetus for Art Street.
Yeah, but
you really
make
were.
It special,
you
Mara.
Really were. So I don't know if you remember that.
But you make
that,
it special, and it's just an honor for me to always speak to you. We just have to do it more often.
We're sitting here in your magnificent house with your extraordinary art. Your love for art and your love for collecting, can you pinpoint a time when that started, or did you always love art?
We visited a museum in St. Paul de Vence in France called the Marc Foundation. And after we visited, it really inspired us to begin collecting. And that occurred in the early 70s. So we've been collecting for a long time and hope to continue collecting for a long time.
I'm sure that you will. I want to start out, Norman, where it all began with Art Basel. You were in on it, involved with it, actually spearheading it right from the beginning. Can you just
even many years before, Norman and I had been attending the fair for 20, 25 years. And we kept telling Lorenzo Rudolph, who directed the Basel Art Fair in Basel, Switzerland, I should consider perhaps a second fair 6 months after the Basel Fair, which is held in June each year. So finally, Lorenzo came to Miami. He saw the community, loved it, and then persuaded the board of Messerschweitz to, hey, let's come to Miami. And fortunately, they bought into it. And when I say buying into it, they decided to make a huge investment. And the marvelous thing about this, there's no government subsidies. There's no taxpayers' dollars that go out to subsidize this fair. This fair was brought here by a for-profit-making company, a Swiss for-profit-making company, who made the investment here. But the benefits to our hotels, to our restaurants, to our image, to everything in the community, it's truly the equivalent of having a Super Bowl here every year, except we don't have to worry about spending $300 million to subsidize it. The economic benefits to the community have been profound. What makes a fair successful from a business standpoint are if the galleries sell, because it's expensive for the galleries to come here. And they had a very successful fair here last December. As I said, it's that collector and gallery, that combination, and that's what makes it a success. But what the galleries do, because of all the attention and the press and everything, they put prize works away to bring here for the fair. So the collectors will see works at these fairs that they just can't see anywhere else at any time, because all the galleries are together. So they can go from one major gallery to whether it's an Aquabella or a Gagosian or a gallery from Europe, and just see the best of what's available in the world. It's almost like visiting a museum as well, a quality museum, and seeing the quality of art that's here. And that's a difficult combination. That's what makes a fair successful. We're not going to duplicate the Museum of Modern Art in New York, or the Whitney Museum, or the Art Institute in Chicago, because they're old established cities. But what we're seeing here is the beginning of perhaps being the contemporary art capital of the United States, with this wonderful mixture of American art coupled with Latin American art, you know, reflecting the community itself here.
So as a so successful businessman, art collector, philanthropist, just activist, do you feel that South Florida is in a greater place than you've ever seen it, than when you came here many, many years ago?
I think so. Without question, all this contributes to the quality of life of the community, which is important. And the thousands of people that visit the fair, this fair has really remained international. It's not a fad type of fair. You'll see works of art here from Picasso to a young 20-year-old artist who has a studio in Wynwood or somewhere in our community, all there in the same building. And that's what makes it interesting here, that it cuts across all types of tastes, all types of interest, both in painting and in sculpture.
Can it make an artist, like, say, a Wynwood artist that maybe gets attention?
I think an artist that has its work shown at the main fair is certainly an indication that that artist has a degree of importance attached to its work, to his or her work. So the answer is yes, it's a milestone.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a milestone, just as it is. It's an honor. It's an honor. It's also brought subsidiary fairs or auxiliary fairs to our community. That's not the way it is in Basel, Switzerland. But you have all these auxiliary fairs that have opened in the design district and sculptural fairs, all centered around Art Basel. So in the case of this particular fair, I honestly believe that the baby has surpassed its parents. I think not only is this the most important fair in the United States, I believe it's the most important art fair in the world.
For information on Art Basel, visit artbaselmiamibeach.com.